gonna do it. He's going to his mouth. Watch.
He's gonna throw the spitter?
Uh-huh.
But that's illegal.
Grow up.
Yeah, that's the Braves for you lowlifes. You think they were in the American League.
Mantle stepping in. What a year the Mick has had. Led the club in home runs with 34. Led the club in average with a 365 mark. For debt ready. Deals. Mantle rips it up the alley. Extra bases.
I wish Mantle was a Dodger.
Who needs Mantle when you've got Snyder?
I know. I love Snyder and I hate Mantle. I'm just saying I would love to be able to love Mantle.
You know, sometimes it's so embarrassing to know you.
I would love to be Mantle. Wouldn't that be great? Hi, I'm Mickey Mantle. That'd be great.
I don't think Antonio knows Mantle.
Really? He knows the Mech?
Sure, he knows a lot of ball players. He works at a gun shop out in the island. He sells the ball players ammo in the offseason when they go big game hunting.
I would love to be a hunter. Hi, I'm Benny Belinsky, the hunter.
Uncle Antonio used to sell ammo to Al Capone before the war.
I would love to be Al Capone.
I would love to smack you if you don't shut up.
Hey, guys, the World Series is on here. Show a little respect.
Now a swing and a foul ball into the crowd, out of play.
We interrupt this program to bring you this special news bulletin. Please stand by.
Oh, no, not right in the middle of the game.
Oh, my God, these are always bad news, aren't they?
Maybe this one's good news, Ben.
Maybe it's space monsters landing all over Brooklyn, like a monster from planet Zoron.
I don't care what it is. They shouldn't be allowed to interrupt a World Series game for anything. Are we living in America?
Here it is.
I can't watch.
Ominous news today from the Soviet Union. Just a few moments ago, that government announced they've launched a powerful rocket into outer space, carrying the world's first man-made satellite, catching the United States and her allies completely off guard. The communists call their satellite Sputnik. For more news, stay tuned to these CBS stations.
A world of its own, the streets where we play, the friends on every corner were the best we ever made. The backyards and the schoolyards and the trees that watched us grow. The days of love when dinner time was all you had to know. Just over the Brooklyn Bridge, that will always be home to me. It'll always be home to me.
This time she's gone too far.
Who?
Aronovitz.
What did she do now?
Don't ask.
Okay, I'm not asking.
I'll tell you what she did. She said some terrible things about Cousin Doris. That's what.
So?
She called her an old maid.
Well, Doris never married.
So?
And she lived to be 96.
No, so?
Well, 96 never married. Doris was an old maid.
Jules,
turn on the TV quick.
What? What happened?
You didn't hear? The Soviets launched a satellite. It was on the car radio. Here, your keys, Jules.
Thanks. The car is running okay?
Yeah, fine. Don't you want to listen to this?
Did it go bading, bading when you started it?
No, it was running fine. Dad, we should listen to the news.
She could have married Hiram Gould. He loved her.
He lived in Oklahoma.
He loved her from afar.
That's just incredible.
What's the matter?
It's the satellite. The Russians put a rocket into outer space.
I always thought we were ahead in the space race.
We're not ahead?
Not anymore.
What's the space race?
I don't know, but if it's a race, we should be ahead.
Do you admire the Russians for doing it or not?
No, definitely not. I said we should have been the first ones to have it, if there's such thing.
I guess the American people are alarmed that a foreign country, especially an enemy country, can do this. And we fear this. We fear that they have something out that majority of the people don't know about.
Definitely alarmed. Yeah.
What do you think about America not being able to do the same?
Well, if I was in military service and fell down on a job like that, I could stand a court-martial. Somebody's fallen down on a job, badly.
Rocketry? Oh, sure, I know quite a bit about rocketry. Did you see Monsters from Planet Zoron?
The one where the alien monsters had two heads?
That's the one. Remember how the monsters' rockets ran out of space gas?
Uh-huh.
Well, apparently the Russians have found a huge space gas well out there in Siberia. That's how they got this Sputnik up off the ground. And now they're taking x-rays of our brains.
Really? Where'd you hear that?
I'm not at liberty to say, but I'll tell you this. That thing is up there right now, threatening our way of life as we know it.
But our science teacher told us that Sputnik is just measuring extra atmospheric pressure and doing simple observations of magnetic fields.
Well, that too.
Hi, Katie. Hey, Mary Beth.
Hi.
Did you hear about Sputnik?
Yeah, isn't it great?
Great? What are you, a commie?
No. I just think it's great for science.
What's this got to do with science?
I can't believe what a bunch of chickens you are. So they got a satellite, so what?
So what if they're spraying us with toxic fumes?
Not likely, Belinsky. Although they could be photographing our internal organs.
Yuck. How come you guys aren't at field hockey practice?
Sister Coach called it off because of Sputnik.
Sister Coach?
That's just her nickname.
Really? She wasn't named after Saint Coach?
Sister Coach is easier than saying her whole regular name.
Which is Sister Bernadette of the Immaculate Martyrdom of the Saints.
Stick with Coach. How can you talk about nuns at a time like this? Can I get a scoop of chocolate, please, Sid?
Would you quit being so jumpy, Ben? You're driving me nuts.
Sorry, but the end of the world makes me a little nervous. Make it strawberry, Sid.
It's not the end of the world. Sister Science says that we're still way ahead in military rocketry.
Sister Science?
Sister Maria Maxima Miracula Immaculata.
Strawberry and chocolate, Sid.
She says that the Soviets can't get a payload of a militarily viable weight into space. Also, their radar, sonar, and solid fuel programs all lack the sophistication of their American counterparts.
You kids are so naive.
As Sputnik orbits our Earth, what secrets of the universe are the communists learning that we in the free world do not yet know?
You think the Russians are really watching us from outer space?
That's what my older brother says.
Wow.
Wow was right. That's why I'm not going outside.
So they can't see us?
I figure if they can't see us, they can't shoot us.
Why would they want to shoot us?
Because they're Russians.
My grandpa's Russian.
That's different. He's a good guy Russian. We're talking about the bad guy Russians.
Oh.
Maybe we should give my Uncle Antonio a call.
The one who works in a gun shop?
Yeah. At a time like this, a rifle might come in handy.
What for?
Let's say Sputnik flies right over our apartment building.
Yeah.
We could shoot it down.
Think it's up there right now?
Sister Science says it'll pass over twice a day. The first time will be tonight.
Who is this Sister Science? A Russian spy?
What if Sputnik's filled with hydrogen bombs and it drops them on us? We're over in Flatbush, then what?
Then we're dead, Ben, and you'll finally shut up.
It's fantastic, isn't it, Alan? I mean, think of the possibilities. A satellite in orbit. It's incredible.
Yeah, but was it worth interrupting the World Series?
Alan.
Aren't you just a little nervous? I mean, what if it really does have toxic fumes or a bomb on it or something?
Don't think about that part. Think about intergalactic space travel and the exploration of the unknown. Think about discovery, not disaster.
You're not Jewish at all, are you?
George says this Sputnik goes all the way around the world, twice a day.
What's the rush?
Hi, Grandma. Hi, Grandpa.
Hello, boys.
What can I get you to eat, boys?
What do you got?
What do I got? What don't I got?
Can Nicky borrow the phone, Grandma? He's got to make a very important call.
Of course, darling.
So is Nicky calling President Eisenhower?
Nope. He's calling his Uncle Antonio at a gun store on Long Island.
Gun store? What's this?
We're going to shoot down Sputnik.
One of the places where the progress of the satellite is being watched most closely is the Hayden Planetarium in New York. CBS News correspondent Richard C. Hotlett reports from there now.
Doug, we're in the great dome of the Hayden Planetarium in New York, and I have with me Dr. Kenneth Franklin, an astronomer on the planetarium staff. Dr. Franklin, can you tell us where the Sputnik is now and how it's moving?
Right now, it's north of Auckland, New Zealand, and moving southeast. It will be, in 10 minutes, about 1,500 miles north of Little America, and in about 24 minutes, it will be over Santiago, Chile, and at about 50 minutes from now, it will be over Spain.
Well, now, I wonder, Dr. Franklin, if you could show us here in the dome of the planetarium how the Sputnik will look to people lucky enough to be able to watch it in twilight.
Well, it'll move very faintly, but I can demonstrate it to you. Can we have the lights out, please? It will apparently come from the northwest first, travel across the sky amongst the stars. They will be visible at this time.
Will it be visible to the naked eye?
Very slightly, if you happen to have good eyes.
Thanks.
You have to go to work tonight?
Only if you want to pay the rent.
You can't switch shifts with Roger or somebody.
Do you want me to?
Well, maybe we should all be together tonight. Just in case.
In case what?
Just in case. I don't know, just in case.
My first reaction, I believe, is the normal reaction of every American. I'm disappointed.
Clean them up good, boys. A clean smoke is a good smoke.
But you hardly ever smoke the pipes, Grandpa.
I know. I'm too busy cleaning them.
So how was your uncle, the gunman, Nicholas?
He's good, but he won't sell me a gun until I'm a little older.
How much older?
53.
Good. We don't need guns in this house.
You don't want to shoot the Russians, Dad?
You shoot at people, they come back madder than ever.
But what if the Russians invade Brooklyn, Mrs. Berger?
The Russians invade Brooklyn, they'll see what nice place we got, they'll move in. They'll be Americans like you and me.
Come over here, everybody. They're about to make a special announcement. Where's Alan?
We can find him.
All right, go get him. Tell him to come right home.
What's this? What's the problem?
I guess Sputnik's almost here.
We've been informed, Doug, that in 62 minutes, Sputnik will pass directly over the United States. State Department sources say the satellite will be in communication with us here on Earth. What we'll hear in just over an hour, no one can say for sure. Back to Douglas Edwards at CBS News Central.
Meanwhile, according to the latest Russian reports, the Sputnik 1 holds its course some 560 miles.
Well, if we're gonna die, I just want you all to know that you were the best friends a guy could ever have.
We're not gonna die.
Yes, we are. If they can get a rocket to outer space, they can get a bomb to America.
Benny's right. They probably do have the technology.
They do?
Probably. The thrust it takes to orbit is probably enough to launch intercontinental ballistic missiles.
Hey, what happened to discovery, not disaster?
Just because they have the capability to blow us up doesn't mean that they're going to.
I don't like the direction this conversation is going.
Me neither.
And I bet the Brooklyn Navy Yards would be a prime target.
That's pretty far away. I mean, it's what, 3 subway stops?
Benny, if an atom bomb hit the Brooklyn Navy Yards, we'd all get completely melted.
Okay, stop it. That's enough, okay? No more talk about blowing up and melting and Sputnik's death rays, okay?
Okay, Warren.
I just don't need to talk about this. You're scared too? Well, maybe a little.
It's okay to be scared. Getting blown up is scary.
So it's getting melted.
Ben!
Sorry. At least we'll all die together.
That's comforting.
Look, if we do die, I just want you guys to know you're the best friends a guy could ever have.
Me too?
Yeah, you too.
Thanks, Warren.
Yeah, thanks, Warren.
And, I really like you too, Katie. In fact, never mind.
What?
Well, since we might die tonight or soon, I guess I'll tell you. If you weren't going out with Alan, I'd want you to go out with me. Because I think you're really pretty and nice. And, well, that's all I wanted to say.
Gosh, I don't know what to say.
Me neither.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
I want to say that since we might blow up and melt tonight, I want to say the same thing Warren said about Katie, except I think I like her even more than he does.
Well, thanks.
Geez, what's going on around here?
More and more teenagers are passing up rock and roll for a rocket roll. Sister Dung Scotus, a physics teacher, supervises members of the Austin, Minnesota Rocket Society attempting to send a mouse aloft. Observers are safely stationed for the tense moments at the countdown.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, fire!
We don't consider our failures as too great disappointments because we know that they're all necessary. We've had many failures, and we learned by each one of them, and we use what we learned to better our next project.
Mom, what are you doing?
I'm making the bed. If the Russians come, I want it should look nice for them.
You think they're going to take a nap?
Well, you never know.
It passes over in less than an hour.
Less than an hour? I'll make some cookies.
What is inside the Sputnik, Professor?
Secret instruments of some kind, or weapons, or... Well, I don't know. I just don't know. No one knows.
It's getting dark. We'll be able to see it soon.
Hard to believe it's really up there.
Yeah.
And we got no gun.
Maybe the Russians are all as nice as my grandpa.
Everybody's pretty worried. My big brother even called from Germany.
The army's on alert, huh?
No, he called to say hello. The big jerk never heard of Sputnik. I had to tell him about it.
He didn't know the Russians launched a rocket?
Hey, He thought he was in Russia. I had to tell him he was in Germany. What a guy.
Nicholas, andiamo.
You know, just in case we get captured or something, you've always been a good pal, Nady.
You too, Nicky. See ya.
See ya.
The question turns from how did the Reds launch Sputnik to why. U.S. scientists say we cannot rule out the possibility that the satellite is bombarding the continental U.S. with dangerous X-rays.
What about you, Katie? You got any secrets?
Not really.
Come on. Warren told his secrets. Ellen told his. Artie told about how I cheated on that test in fourth grade, how I smoked half of Mrs. Skolnick's cigarette last summer, and about every girl I've ever had a crush on.
You really don't want to die with even one secret, do you, Ben?
Nobody's gonna die.
This is the Russians we're talking about. Rumor has it they're not crazy about Americans.
You don't have any secrets at all. Come on, you gotta have one secret.
Okay. Okay. I have one.
What is it?
I don't want to say.
Oh, this really is not fair. Come on, Katie.
All right. Last month at a party, I kissed Joey DeForest.
You what?
See, I knew I shouldn't have told you.
You kissed DeForest? He's 19.
Alan.
Disaster and humiliation. These are the results of America's first attempts to get ahead in the space race. Can we ever catch up with the Soviets? Or does Sputnik mean this race is already over, with the gold medal going to the Soviet Union? Science.
What keeps it up there, Grandpa?
I think maybe it has wings.
You don't think it's the Earth's gravity pulling it down and the centripetal force it generates pushing it away, locking it in orbit?
No, I think it's wings.
It's very impressive, Nathaniel. Where'd you hear all that in school?
Yeah, we talked all about elliptical orbits and atmospheric reentry. I don't know what any of it means, but it's fun to say the words.
Keep talking, Nathaniel. You sound like a genius to me.
He is a genius.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Berger.
Hello, Elgar. What's all this?
Well, it's stuff the kids have left in my store over the years. I was going to sell it all, but now with the Sputnik...
I know, we're all going to die. Everyone's talking. I heard it already.
Since you saw name tags into the Silver's clothes, I thought I'd return them.
It's very nice, Elgar.
You know, Mrs. Berger, we've never been too close, but seeing this could be...
This could be what?
Well, seeing this could be our last night, maybe we should get to know each other better.
Let's not.
No?
No. For what? If it ends, so it's over. Then what? Who needs the Mishigos?
This is a tough family.
Our satellite program has never been conducted as a race with other nations. Rather, it has been carefully scheduled as part of the scientific work of the International Geophysical Year.
Reporters looked on in disbelief as a Sheikh and Eisenhower tried to dispel the fears of a nation in shock.
Up here.
You okay?
Me? Never better. The Russians are gonna blow us all up. And my girlfriend's out kissing every 19-year-old in Brooklyn, but...
Not every 19-year-old. One 19-year-old and one kiss. He wasn't a very good kisser.
Oh, brother, I don't want to hear this.
I don't even know how it happened. My cousin had a party, and... Joey was there, and I was there, and he's the only other boy I've ever kissed.
Spare me the details.
And as soon as I kissed him, I felt just terrible. Because, well, because I don't really like Joey DeForest. I really like you. Do you really like me?
Yeah. That's sort of a universal feeling around here, isn't it?
You know, Alan. My mother always says that it's not easy to be a teenager.
But it's easy for Joey DeForest.
You're really mad, aren't you?
Yeah. No, I'm less mad, but I'm still mad.
Mm-hmm.
the Soviet satellite now in deep space, scientists all over the world try to track the mysterious orbiter with radar and sonar to learn just what the Russians are up to.
Of course they're spying up there. What else do you think they're doing?
I don't know, experiments.
You think they give a hoot about the Earth's crust?
That's what they say.
Hell no. What the Russians say and what the Russians mean are two different things. They're communists. You can't trust them.
They make a good vodka. There's nothing like a Russian vodka, especially from Russia.
Well, on that, I'll give in. They do a marvelous job with their vodka, which I might add I could get you a good deal on.
Under a minute to go.
I don't feel anything yet, do you?
No, not yet. I feel something.
What, Ma?
I feel good to have the whole family here, together like it should be. Sputnik or no, I think it's beautiful. Now, who needs another cookie?
We just received a report, Doug, that Sputnik is approaching the United
States.
Turn it up. Scientists here say that in less than 10 seconds, the Soviet satellite will begin its journey over the North American continent, passing first over Washington State. Wait. Yes, Sputnik is now over the continental U.S. for the first time, Doug, moving over Yakima, Washington, and heading toward the East Coast. We're getting... Yes? Yes, we're getting a signal, Doug. Listen now for the first sounds from outer space.
That's it?
We've lost our signal, Doug. Sputnik is now over the Atlantic, moving away from the United States.
So that's the whole thing?
I guess that's all there was to it.
I love you guys. I love you guys so much.
State Wait. Department sources now report that Sputnik has no military capabilities, Doug. The White House is joining many other nations in sending the Soviets congratulations on a job.
Who wants more cookies?
Wait, listen.
Radio Moscow reports the Soviets will launch another satellite in 2 months.
Oh, my God.
Answer
We're going to die.
From Moscow. Hmm. Proud words from the government whose scientists shot this first sound.
Until 2 days ago, that sound had never been heard on this earth. Suddenly, it has become as much a part of 20th century life as the whir of your vacuum cleaner. It's a report from man's farthest frontier, the radio signal transmitted by the Soviet Sputnik, the first man-made satellite as it passed over New York earlier today.
What should you do when you have a problem? Call C.J. Ward and 47 on your side. More Valley residents turn to C.J. Ward for help than anywhere else. Put C.J. Ward on your side. Only on 47 Eyewitness News.
Sit, Ubu, sit. Good dog.